noise gate is a feature which allows you to readjust the volume level of an audio signal once it has fallen below a specific threshold. When gating in FL Studio, the Fruity Limiter is my go-to plugin. Upon opening the Fruity Limiter, you'll see that there's a noise gate section in the bottom right-hand corner. This is the section we're going to be focusing on for this video. You'll see that there are only three parameters. REL stands for release, and this parameter determines how long it takes for the noise gate to kick in. Gain determines the volume that your signal will be played at once the noise gate has kicked in. And Thresh stands for threshold, and this determines when the noise gate begins to kick in. When dialing in a noise gate, I tend to first drop the gain knob down to zero. This makes it easiest to hear the noise gate working and can be readjusted later if need be. Next, I begin to adjust the threshold. You want to set it so that the audio that you would like to hear peaks above the threshold, and so that the audio that you don't want to hear falls below the threshold. Any bit of the signal which falls below the threshold will be reduced to the volume set by the gain knob. Lastly, if the gate is being triggered either too quickly or too slowly, you can smooth out the transition by adjusting the release knob. There are two major ways to use a noise gate. One is to use it more as a utility, and the other is to use it more as an effect. If you've ever recorded your voice through a microphone, you may have noticed some unwanted room noise during the pauses between vocal phrases. A quick way to eliminate this noise from your recording is to run it through a noise gate. Applying a noise gate will allow you to control which bits of your audio signal get through the gate, as well as those that don't. Line recordings also tend to contain unwanted noise. If you've ever worked with the recording of a distorted guitar, you may have noticed a bit of a hum when the instrument isn't playing. This can also easily be fixed with a noise gate. Gating can also be helpful when working with recordings from various other instruments. One example might be the audio from a snare mic. Maybe the tail of the snare is too long and is interfering with other elements of your mix, or maybe the snare mic is picking up bleed from other drum mics. Rather than manually going in and slicing out the unwanted sections, why not apply a noise gate and let it do the work for you? Rhythmic gating is probably most pronounced in the genre of trance music, where you'll often hear a sustained synth that is rhythmically gated to produce a strobe-like effect. However, the concept of rhythmic gating can pretty much be applied wherever you see fit. This effect is probably most widely recognized in 80s-style music, where snares or toms were commonly drenched in reverb and then gated to create a unique effect. The infamous tom fill in Phil Collins's In the Air Tonight is a classic example of this technique, and is achieved by placing a reverb before a noise gate in the processing chain.